And he's doing the smart thing there, Paula, tucking in behind the taller figures there, but they're all head down, bowed into the wind. But look at Geoffrey Kumworo. This is incredible from him.
This is amazing. See just why we lost the pictures there with the wind. Rain now coming down, it's almost horizontal rain, and I would say that Mo didn't need an umbrella there because he might have been like Mary Poppins going backwards in the wrong direction. So I think he's doing the job now of trying to shelter him, but look how quickly that gap has opened up. And certainly we talked about that 10k split for Karakiv, 27:31. That obviously has done damage to him. I think he's paying the price for those surges we saw in the early stages, but Kumworo is just phenomenal that he's been. He's one man who is pretty much unbeatable on the cross country, on the road, won world titles at those distances, and then does have that silver medal on the track. So if we were to have a grand slam of distance racing, as there's been some talk about trying to encourage interest in cross country again and to kind of build that up, he would be the man who is the most hotly tipped to be able to do that in the near future. Well, on the track to be able to do that, though, of course.
Well, he's certainly, for me, added to all of our adulation of him as an athlete, because to fall at the start in the way which he did, and if it weren't for these conditions at the end, at the very least he would have run a personal best here. He's not going to be too far off it. That 5K split 14:25, as Paula was saying, Kuroki in particular has paid for that. Look at that gust of wind almost blowing Kumworo over. Mo Farah there trying to work hard. Look at the debris being blown across the road. He's being cheered on. The fans trying to do their best here, but incredibly difficult conditions for the athletes. When you get out, when you're protected, and then you go across a street junction, the wind can suddenly come whipping in from the side and upset your balance. But this guy, Paula, he's going to run close to 59 minutes. His best is 58:54. He would have run in a sensible race with not falling down, etc., conditions to contend with, particularly in these last 2 or 3 miles. He's still going to run an incredibly quick time, looking behind, but hats off to him. Well, yeah, your hats have all been blown off, but you know what I mean.
Well, he lost his hat at the start, didn't he? And I think if you look at that, even those pictures again from the start, he was at least 10 seconds, if not 15 seconds, actually on the floor before he got up again and was running. So even if you take out all of the factors of the impact and whether he bruised or hurt anywhere, when he fell, there were athletes clambering over his back. The fact that he got up, that he moved up so quickly to be able to close that gap and then really controlled this race. And I think he has to thank Karakiv as well for the way they've worked together in not being wilted by the conditions. And I think they're approaching now the turn in, so it is going to be very low, 59 minutes.
Geoffrey Kumworo of Kenya, the world cross-country champion. And he's won this one before. He's the world silver medalist on the track, but this may well be one of his best performances ever. He's going to cross the winning line, or the finish line, to win the world half marathon title in the world conditions in Cardiff in a very, very quick time, given everything that happened today, including falling at the finish line, picking himself up, having to pick himself up, get himself back in the race, catch everybody else. Then one by one, they all fell away. His teammate, Bidan, will take the silver medal. And as Paula said, he perhaps should be thanked for the way in which he Kumworo away from the field. The two of them at times, 7:31, the middle 10K. Great track pace. And talking about track pace, Mo Farah with his big traditional sprint at the end. He's going to try and hold off Ayala for the bronze medal. Is he going to do it? Ayala's coming back at him. Farah takes one more look behind and just checks. He gets the bronze medal for Great Britain. Mo Farah crosses the line just inside 60 minutes. Well done to him. That was hard. And he will take with him a European record on the roads over 15 kilometers as well. A tough, tough race, and that a result which I think Mo will be absolutely delighted with. A real testimony to his endurance, because to go out as hard as he did, they tried to destroy him, as they did with many of the others. He ended up coming through, biding his time a little bit. He was still running very, very fast, but staying strong in the latter stages.
Runner, 5100m 世界纪录保持者。 咁啊，上屆世界錦標賽1萬米又係攞第一。今年奧運嗰個金牌咧，攞1.5個咁滯嘅啦。咁睇下今日嘅越野賽啊，作為賽呢個大賽前一個熱身咧，佢嚟講咧有冇難度啦？咁啊，男子方面咧就跑12公里嘅，跑2個細圈加4個大圈，咁啊係咁兜，係咁兜。 條路咧路面真係跑完幾個組別之後咧，就比較難下噶啦。跑到呢個階段，會唔會對個賽事有影響咧？嗱，睇到啊，地下比較黑，即係啲草咧就踩到爛晒。咁啊，隊制方面咧就會每一個加派9位運動員出嚟，咁啊計頭6名，將個總分加埋去咧，就邊個分最少咧就係成為總冠軍。 咁啊，埃塞俄比亞咧就派859人參加。咁睇睇啊，其實呢個賽事咧有459人參加，成個賽事都相當之熱鬧嘅，好多國家都支持，有133個國家參加，話都算係呢個奧運會之前嘅熱身賽，比較大型嘅賽事。咁睇翻前面咧，就埃塞俄比亞比基里咧就。 因為實力超群啦，佢都唔想話呢度後面俾人阻到啊、踩到啊咁啦，因為之前咧幾個組別都見到啦，有啲運動員啊俾人撞跌咗又有，或者踩親啊，甚至啊鞋都甩埋嘅，所以都唔好啦，走咗喺前面穩陣啲。咁啊跑到呢度咧就大家好近嘅個距離都，比基利啊帶頭。 因為個地啊比較跣下㗎，睇下會唔會話？又突然間窒咗下喎，比基利做咩事咧？係咪抽筋啊？哎呀，唔係啊，俾人踩甩對鞋喎，又係，哎麻煩啦！大熱門，望望其他選手望下要去咗邊啊？因為佢實力超群㗎嘛，慘啦，咁就好難追喎，幾十位運動員喺前邊，哎真係唔見咗，哎咁啊麻煩啦！咁其他隊友靠你哋啦，睇下佢可唔可以追到上嚟啦？睇翻前面啊，真係～ 借得紅衫為主，或者偉肯啊，埃塞俄比亞選手睇下呢度啊，比基利帶得好地地嘅呢位世界紀錄，突然間窒下窒下，以為拉親又唔係喎，原來甩咗對鞋，估唔到帶頭都俾人踩到對鞋啊，冇辦法啦，因為佢都呢次都正噶啦，盡量就唔好擺喺後邊人群當中啊，因為正話跌低咗好多運動員嘅個賽道比較跣，都要俾人踩親，咁啊麻煩啲啦，因為大熱門可唔可以追得翻呢？ 十二K嘅佢有實力咧，都唔一定話冇機會。點解呢？因為開始嘅時間大家都唔快，你睇到呢度咧咁多運動員，成扎人攆埋一齊嘅，那個速度咧唔係好快。誒，比基利追下追下又追嚟追翻近好多咯。哇！喳喳聲追翻上去啊！佢啊經驗夠啦，雖然話咁遠啫，佢唔會話突然間心急一下加速啦，追慢慢追，走翻自己節奏。124號呢位63選手啊！ 因為佢見到前面距離都係50米到咧，咁佢自己有信心有把握咧，就走翻自己速度啊。始終前面嘅速度唔係太快，咁佢寧願採取慢慢跟啊睇翻啊呢個慢動作發生咩事，係咪俾人哋踢親一腳啊？又話係點咧？哎，真係可能係俾人踩一踩，佢嘅反應好快啊，即刻著翻鞋。 但已經輸咗成40米，都不得止，仲要一扎人擋住佢，哇！好快，10零分鐘佢就追翻上嚟，哦，又係個頭啦，冇影響。其實其他嘅對手咧就唔知道啦，可能唔知道佢自己個最強對手啊甩咗佢鞋。如果唔係咧，喺嗰段嚟發力，盡量拉開佢咧，咁啊有着數噶啦。咁但係你仲係慢慢揼咧，就益咗佢啦。咁啊追下追下，追翻晒上嚟。 都未跑到一半就已經追咗上嚟啦，咁啊麻煩啦你哋睇睇，跑下跑下得4位運動員喺前面啫。呢位就比較特別啦，喺納特里亞呢位非洲選手泰迪斯，佢帶頭喎呢次，泰迪斯個成績都好好噶，喺上屆上年啊有個世界公路錦標賽嘅。 冠軍嚟嘅，20K 跑56分，好快下嘅。咁啊，奧運會咧就1萬米第3㗎，相當有實力嘅。 佢越野賽都得嘅，佢越上屆嘅世界越野賽嘅冠軍嚟嘅。睇睇依次點啦？不過俾阿比基尼咁快追翻上嚟咧，就佢都驚驚地嘅啦。所以佢哋如果知道比基尼係俾人踩親對鞋，墮後咁遠咧，我相信佢哋肯定喺嗰度咧，盡快發力拉開佢，唔好俾佢追近。咁而家咁快俾佢追近咧，就大家知道個賽果都係點嘅啦。係比基尼嘅出名就係爆發力好、速度好，佢五千米嘅世界紀錄亦都冇人能夠接近嘅。咁你俾佢跟得住咧，都幾咁麻煩。睇下啦。泰迪斯仲是帶頭，但係佢上身咧就縮埋跑嘅，因為始終呢個路程咧就比較艱辛啲。另外兩位肯亞選手啊，高蒙啊、伊貝亞咁都跟到實。伊貝亞就想過又過唔到喎，肯亞高嗰位運動員第三喎，而家追下都係一字長射。咦！有啲運動員俾人贏一圈啦，已經冇辦法。始終嗰個實力上有啲差距，好啦，盡量走啦。呢位泰迪斯係亞納特利亞嘅運動員嚟嘅，上屆冠軍，佢希望今屆可唔可以蟬聯咧？但係比基尼咧就好似忍唔住腳想過去咯。而家先跑28分幾，而家如果12K 嚟講，都要33、34分左右嘅時間先完成到嘅。咁早啊，開始加速，因為知道而家再唔加速咧，就拉唔開比基尼咧，就好難贏到佢噶啦。但加下，自己都冇埋，縮埋咗個人啦，已經俾兩位肯亞選手咧過埋佢。嚟到呢度，28分42秒跑咗比基尼，差唔多其實四個選手暫時嚟講，高蒙啊。都是跟到好貼肯亞運動員，同埋另一個肯亞選手伊貝亞，四個拉開曬啦。第五位都好遠好遠，起碼都100米以後噶啦。嚟到度講求戰略同埋睇邊個速度好噶啦。比基尼，哇！讓賽讓咗你50米追上嚟，到依家又係佢帶頭。哇！上身真係好靚啊，跑得好輕鬆，相當鬆嘅。所以雖然而家長跑咧叫好講求耐力咧，但係嚟到依家世界級嘅選手嚟講咧，都好講求速度。佢隨時最尾一圈咧就爆一個53秒嘅嚟嘅，咁佢就咁走個400，估計都唔使50秒嘅。咦，捋下呢個阿納特里亞嘅上屆冠軍泰迪斯就唔肯放棄喎，已經縮埋個人啦，跑到好辛苦噶啦。俾人過咗之後咧，都盡量唔俾拉開，希望咧臨尾嗰段咧仲可以跑得起嘅。好啦，嚟啦，比基尼等你啦，走啦，仲有千零米佢啊開始發力啦。雖然條路好爛下，跑到哇，佢啲腳步真係好輕鬆，同埋頻率好高嘅，純粹用速度去同你跑，邊有跟啊？冇得跟啦。後面拉開外線，不要阻住帶頭的選手。好，個人表演賽比基尼大甩曬啦！睇下最後400米會不會又有個強勁的衝刺嚟俾大家睇啦！後面反而2、3、4名咧，仲係好近下。兩位肯亞運動員高蒙啊，同埋伊貝亞咧，就夾住一個。阿納特里亞的泰迪斯到5、6、7、8位其實都相當近嘅，雖然拉開到好遠嘅，包括肯亞的摩斯馬沙、卡塔爾的傑保利啊，同埋另一位選手肯亞的尼加杜尼咧，都是爭取一個對制的金牌、銀牌咁樣嘅。睇到啦，哦，比基尼又是嚟到最後400米，會唔會就？表演個跑50幾秒400米俾大家睇咧，不過呢度因為斜路嘅400米咧，就好難跑到50幾秒噶啦。同埋佢都夠贏就算噶啦，知道後邊都冇人上嚟望下，哇幾廿米 keep 住就算數啦。到呢個階段佢上身仲係咁穩定，同埋嗰個擺手好輕鬆。 呢段路咧就最考功夫啊，因為呢條斜路你嚟到跑12K 去到呢一段再衝個斜路咧，相當吃力嘅。睇下後邊啦，高蒙214號啊，呢度開始踩油啊，泰迪斯以為冇，以為冇啦，縮下縮下又再跟住你喎。上屆冠軍都希望攞唔到個冠軍，攞亞軍啦，唔好獎牌攞唔到啊慘啦，所以佢都盡量跟住高蒙。 希望臨尾可唔可以衝翻過去啊？咁啊，高蒙咧就比較腳比較長啊，好鬆啊，大步落車拉翻開啦。比基利知道贏緊嘅咧就唔係好加速啫，保持個速度啫。反而後邊二三四位咧就好近啊，高蒙啊，可唔可以追翻近啊？比基利啊，比基利望一望你唔衝啊，啊！ 二三名咧，爭爭得好激烈喎！高蒙同埋泰迪斯，泰迪斯又想過翻去，過唔到啦，嚟到呢度一人一步，有距離都過唔翻啦。第三名就泰迪斯，第四名另一位肯亞運動員伊貝亞，咦，五六七八都唔知去曬邊，冇人跟到。比基利作為奧運會前一個熱身賽，好輕鬆，暫時真係世界都冇乜人跟到佢。 咁啊，今年個奧運1萬米金牌，相信都難到佢啦。反而後邊啊幾位卡塔爾嘅選手啦，雖然前身都係非洲籍嘅運動員嚟嘅，咁啊移民咗過去，都滿意啦，攞到第6名啦。呢位傑寶利同埋另一位咧就阿巴甸就跑第8。咁啊，肯雅一紮運動員翻嚟，仲未見到埃塞俄比亞啲運動員。 雖然埃塞俄比亞有投嗰兩個，第一名係佢攞啦，但後邊嗰扎咧就唔生性啦，好厚啊，所以對制方面咧，肯亞咧就攞到個總冠軍，佢哋39分嘅，咁啊埃塞俄比亞105分，哇，輸好遠下喎，即係始終男仔嚟講啊，平均咧都係肯亞運動員咧就絕對嘅優勢嘅。 咁啊，第三嘅對制成績咧，第三名嘅成績咧就係卡塔爾，呢位亞洲嘅長跑強國啊，贏埋日本隊啊，比基利34分38秒，相當好成績啊！